Veronica Gale here with your 89.5 coronavirus update for May 12th. New York City has 52 confirmed cases of pediatric multisystem inflammatory syndrome, which is associated with COVID-19. 25 of those 52 cases also tested positive for the coronavirus, 22 others had antibodies, and there has been one fatality so far. De Blasio encourages parents to call their pediatrician immediately if their child has any of these symptoms: persistent fever, rash, abdominal pain, or vomiting. In other news, the House is voting this Friday on a $3 trillion coronavirus relief package. $500 billion would go to local governments, and another $500 billion would go to the states. It would also include direct payments with $1,200 per family member and up to $6,000 per household. $175 billion would go towards homeowners' monthly rent, and $200 billion would go to a hero fund, which is for frontline workers to make sure they are receiving a fair pay. Lastly, a new online trading platform lets hospitals trade medical supplies. This online platform was created because some hospitals have a surplus of certain items due to private donations, government allocations, or shipments ordered months ago finally arriving. This new platform lets hospitals trade items they have a lot of for items they are struggling to find, sharing the wealth. That is it for today's coronavirus news update. Make sure you follow us on Instagram and check out our website, wcu.net, for more information. Reporting for WCU News, I'm Veronica Gale.